हेलो स्टूडेंट, हाउ आर यू? नाउ एग्जाम डेट इज डिक्लेयर्ड, सो आई डू होप दैट यू विल बी वेरी सीरियस. सो नाउ यू शुड स्टार्ट प्रिपरेशन विद विगरस एंड यू कैन से कंसिस्टेंट एफर्ट्स. सो यू हैव वन मंथ एंड वन वीक ऑल्सो इन हैंड, सो यू रिक्वायर टू डू वेरी सीरियसली. वन थिंग आई विल लाइक टू से दैट ऑन टूडे टू टूडे ऑनवर्ड्स देर विल नॉट बी टॉपिक वाइज टेस्ट. नाउ देर विल बी रेगुलर टेस्ट. So we will have at least four tests in the meanwhile. And one thing more I will like to say, as my topics are supposed to finish now, one or two classes I will take to complete second paper or section two. Then I will request all students whosoever listening my lecture, if they are writing exam this year and they have any sort of difficulty in any topic, even though I have done already, you ask me, you record, you tell me, I will come do it again, because I feel that your competence, your confidence is very much important where the exam is concerned. So please don't feel any sort of hesitation, and let me know if you have any sort of difficulty. Today I will start administrative reform in India. This topic is, you can say, last topic of section 2. BPS, in BPS exam there has been question from this topic, I tell you, but as I told earlier that due to change of exam pattern, so only important questions are now being addressed and some less important aspects are being ignored. As a result, administrative reform topic is also ignored for a long period. Last it came in 1956-59 BPSC, afterward there has not been question from this topic. This year we are expecting, so we will, and earlier also there have been question of this topic. Sometime question come on Indian reform in admission reform in India, sometime question come on admission reform in Bihar, so they are required to understand this topic properly. Getting point? What is administrative reform? If someone asks you, then what you will say? Administrative reform is basically an artificial transformation of artificial transformation to bridge the gap between administrative desirability and administrative availability. You know, administration is ecological process and administration is situational organic process. As being ecological process, there has been throughout changes in ecology which requires changes in administration, and as being, you can say, organic process, it develops wear and tear in course of time and it requires correction also. So these two requirements may say, cause a necessity of administrative reform. So administrative reform is universal phenomena. It has been always in past also, and it is in other country you can find there is administrative reform also. So what I mean to say, that administrative reform is basically, you can say, some sort of deliberate efforts, and it has moral responsibility also. So as administration is moral responsibility, that's why administrative reform is also moral responsibility. And you know, there is some sort of resistance also, because if you want to change a status quo, then that it will cause a strain and it will cause some sort of repercussion also. So you require to understand three things, that administrative reform is some sort of artificial transformation, number one, number two, it has moral objective, and number three, it has resistance. It is to be bridge the gap between requirement and availability. Getting a point? You know, in India there has been administrative reform from time immemorial. If you see, during Mauryan administration, Kautilya has brought significant changes in administration. During Sultanate period, there was also significant changes. Then during Mughal administration, particularly during Akbar period, there had been significant administrative reform. During British rule, administrative reform started since 1773. Which continued till 1935. Get a point? And after independence, the administrative reform started, which continues today. So what was major changes in independence? What is importance of independence in admission reform in India? You can say independence is basically most important landmark in the administrative reform process in India. Independence brought the changes in rule from colonial rule to self-rule, you can say, independent government rule. And it has also introduced welfare state notion. It also introduced socio-economic planning, development, administration, resolution of socialistic pattern of society. Get a point? And India inherited, number of socio-economic problem and colonial legacy from British rule. So what it was required, on the one hand, it has number of role and responsibility to perform. On the other hand, it has number of bottlenecks wheresoever administrative structure is concerned. That's why after independence, India required administrative reform. Getting point? And it started, which continues till now. When you talk of administrative reform consists of structural reform, procedural reform, and behavioral reform. Structural reform is political change reform, political process, which requires consent from political executive, and behavioral reform is very difficult. It does not change overnight. It takes time to be corrected. And where procedural reform is concerned, it is, you can say, regular phenomena. And in general, government or administration undertakes procedural reform regularly. But structure, process, and behavior all are integrated. Get my point? If a structure is complicated, procedure will be also complicated, and behavior will be cumbersome. And if a structure is small, procedure will be simple, and behavior will be simple also. So there is some sort of interrelation between these three components. As I told that India after independence registered a significant political reform, significant administrative reform. Then what sort of administrative reform it has? We can classify them on the basis of several count. On the basis of time period, we can classify that before 1964, what were administrative reform? After 1964 to 92, what were administrative reform? Or 2005, what were administrative reform, and 2005 onwards, what were administrative reform. Here we divide on the basis of first ARC and second ARC. On the basis of subject also, like personal administrative reform in personal administration, administrative reform in financial administration, we can classify. On the basis of, you can say, reform based on committee and reform without recommendation of committee, on that basis also we can classify administrative reform. On the basis of issue, like some administrative reform is were directed to corruption, some administrative reform were to bring efficiency, some administrative reform were concerned with decentralization. On that basis we can also classify them. On the basis of nature, some administrative reform are of preventive nature, some administrative reform is negative nature. Means curbing corruption or check corruption, etc., are negative type of administrative reform. And right to information, citizen charter, are a positive type of administrative reform. So the administrative reform are of various type in it. The nature is very multiple, you can say, in present perspective. Getting point? If you look at, in general, what sort of administrative reform took place in India, I tell you, 1964 as the major point, because before 1964 all administrative reform were of piecemeal nature, and they were segmental in character. But in 1964 first significant change took place, that Government of India established administrative reform department under Ministry of Home Affairs. So that was very important. So before 1964, what were administrative reform which took place in piecemeal approach were, first, there was Secretarial Reorganization Committee constituted in 1947 under the chairmanship of Girja Shankar Bajpayee. It was established to reorganize secretarial system after partition. You know, first pay commission in 1946 is constituted and gave report in 1947 under chairmanship of Bhardwajacharya. Getting one, this is also very important. In 1948, Kasturbhai Lal Bhai, under the chairmanship of Kasturbhai Lal Bhai, its economy committee was constituted, which has given measures to control expenditure in various administration department of government of India. In 1949, N. Gopal Swami Iyengar committee was constituted. It has given recommendation for organization, reorganization of various ministry and department. It also gave recommendation for O&M, but credit goes to Appalabhi. Getting point? In 1951, Gorwala report was given on two subjects, and it has also given recommendation for establishment O&M. In 1952, R.A. Gopal Swami's committee was constituted. It has given recommendation to bring efficiency in secretarial system. In 1953, American expert Paul Appleby visited India. It has investigated Indian system in detail. It has given one report in 1953, another report in 1956. On the basis of recommendation of Appalabhi, IIPA was established and O&M was established. You know, Appalabhi visited Bihar and termed Bihar administration as best administrative state. He quoted Bihar administrative system as the best administrative system that time. Getting away? In 1953-54, Ashok Chanda has given recommendation for creating more All India services, delegation of power, etc. But this report was not submitted. In 1955, corruption charges against railway was witnessed, and to investigate, Railway Corruption Inquiry Committee was constituted under the chairmanship of J.B. Kriplani. 1956 also, you know, Mudaliar Committee was constituted on the civil service reform. 1957 is important year because this year Balwant Rai Mehta Committee was constituted, which has recommended for democratic decentralization, which is known as Panchayati Raj Institution. In 1959, Second Pay Commission was constituted under the chairmanship of Jagannath Das. At a point in 1962, V.T. Krishnamachari Committee was constituted on training and recruitment of civil services. 1964, another very important year. Yeah, this year, you know, under chairmanship of K. Santhanam, Committee on Prevention of Corruption was established. It has given recommendation to constitute Central Vigilance Commission. Getting a point? So this is very important thing. 1964 also, I told, in Ministry of Home Affairs, Department of Administrative Reform was created. That was very established one, very important one. Get a point? In 1966, under the chairmanship of Morarji Desai, later on he replaced by K. Hanumantayya, first Administrative Reform Commission was constituted. It was major thrust after independence, because after independence, India adopted socio-economic planning. It established planning commission, which has brought significant changes in administrative structure to investigate into and give correct major recommendation. First ARC was constituted. It has given 20 reports and 580 recommendations, in which the creation of Lokpal, Lok Ayog, separation of audit and accounting, introduction of sandwich course training for civil services, death system in secretarial arrangement, this determining size of Council of Ministers and Cabinet, index system in filing system of secretariat, were significant recommendation. Performance budgeting, getting point. So it has given several recommendation, getting point, and several recommendation is were also accepted also. In 1973, Third Pay Commission under Raghubar Dayal was constituted. In 1975, LP Singh and LK Jha has given recommendation on improving efficiency in administration. Getting point. In 1966, Principal Service Exam, D.S. Kothari Committee was constituted. On its recommendation, prelim was introduced. Uniform civil combined civil service exam was introduced. In 1978, Ashok Mehta Committee was constituted on Panchayati Raj, which has given recommendation for two-tier Panchayati Raj institution. Get a social audit, introduction of social audit in Panchayati Raj institution, parties involvement of political party in Panchayati Raj institution. But since government changed, so its recommendations were not given serious consideration. In 1978, National Police Commission was constituted under chairmanship of Dharamveera. That was major administration reform in police administration. It has given eight recommendation in eight part, eight chapter you can say. It's a significant recommendation are yet to be implemented now. Getting point. So in 2006, Supreme Court has given directive to central government on the plea of PIL filed by Sri Prakash Singh. Getting point. But still the recommendation of National Police Commission yet to be implemented. Next, in 1980, under the chairmanship of LK Jha, Economic Reform Committee was constituted. In 1984, significant changes took place as far as center-state relation is concerned. In 1983, under the chairmanship of Ranjit Singh Sarkaria, Central State Commission was constituted, which has given recommendation for constitution of establishment of inter-state council, giving constitutional status to Panchayati Raj, giving recommendation for impartial selection and function of governor, use of 356, etc. In 1986, Fourth Pay Commission was constituted under P.N. Singhal, Chairman Singh of P.N. Singhal. In 1989, again, Civil Service Reform Committee was constituted under Satish Chandra Committee. It has given introduction of essay paper and elevation of interview marks from 250 to 300. Getting a point? In 1992 can be termed as very important year, because on the one hand it has witnessed LPG worldwide economic reform, on the other hand democratic decentralization, and here 73rd and 74th amendment came, which gave constitutional status to Panchayati Raj institution and municipal body. In 1997, first fifth pay commission was constituted under chairmanship of Ratnawal. In 1998, under the chairmanship of P.C. Jain, a commission on review of administrative law was constituted. It found that India has more than 200 administrative law, in which more than two-thirds are meaningless and useless now. They require to be replaced. And now, when Modi government came in power, it's eliminated or abolished almost all administrative law which were irrelevant now. Get a point? In 2001, you can say, under the chairmanship of K.P. Geetha Krishnan, Expenditure Reform Commission was constituted. In 2001 itself, Y.K. Alag Committee was constituted under the chairmanship of for Civil Service Exam System. Get a point? Geetha Commission, Expenditure Reform Commission has given recommendation to constitute Expenditure Commission on the tune of Finance Commission. Get a point? And Alag Committee has given to bring significant changes in recruitment of civil services. In 2002, National Commission on, you can say, working of Indian Constitution, that was under chairmanship of Venkat Chalaiya. The NDA government has constituted this commission to review functioning of Indian Constitution, Indian Constitution after 50 years of independence, and to suggest measure. It has given several recommendations, but since due to change in political system, the recommendations were dropped in, you can say, called storage. Now, in 2003, Yugandhar committee was constituted for in service training, and it has given recommendation training in civil service training services. In 2003 itself, Surendranath committee has given recommendation of performance appraisal of civil servant. In 2003, Malimath committee was constituted on reform of criminal civil justice, criminal justice system. In 2004, Khota committee was constituted to bring changes in recruitment and civil service exam. In 2005, again the significant year, here RTI was introduced, right to information was introduced, National Disaster Management Authority was constituted, and under the chairmanship of Veerappa Moily, second ARC was constituted. It was established to accommodate new changes after LPG and 21st century situation. It has given 15 reports, and with all reports are very challenging and very relevant one, and maximum report, several recommendations were accepted also. But again, due to change in government, its recommendations are delayed and yet to be implemented. In 2006, under the chairmanship of Soli Saurabji, Police Act Drafting Committee was constituted to frame new Police Act to replace Indian Police Act 1861. In 2008, UNOP 6 Pay Commission was constituted under B.N. Sri Krishna. In 2010, Second Administrative Reform Commission on Central State Relations under the chairmanship of Madan Mohan Punchi was constituted. In 2014, Lokpal was appointed by UPA government. The institution of Lokpal was created by UPA government in 2015. Planning Commission was replaced by Niti Aayog. 2017, you can say again, the railway budget was removed. It was merged with general budget. Planned expenditure and planned expenditure classification was merged. So this type of significant changes we are doing present also. And there is, you can say, endless story of administrative reform. And if you analyze the overall view of administrative reform in India, you find it has mixed response. Some administrative reform are very successful, and some area of in which administrative reform are yet to be effective one. Wherever you can say budget is concerned, audit is concerned, you can say Lokpal, public citizen grievances are concerned, significant changes took place, and but wherever police reform is concerned, criminal justice reform is concerned, prison reform is concerned, decentralized planning is concerned, desirable result is yet to come. So what I mean to say, but administrative reform is very important. Presently, if you see, the present government is very much serious about administrative reform, and now it has brought very significant changes wherever administrative reform is concerned. Earlier there were some sort of vision, action, dichotomy situation. Means administrative reform commission were constituted, they gave recommendation. Now it was up to government to adopt or not. But now the situation is removed. Now action, vision are accommodated now. Niti Aayog is taking up both role. It's also visualizing and implementing it. That's why government was in position to implement several extraordinary decisions like demonetization, GST, lockdown, etc. So now one thing more about I mean to say that there's some sort of the replacement of your planning commission by Niti Aayog has brought significant changes in administrative reform. Now it has become, you can say, hub of administrative reform process. We have formulation, implementation, and evaluation, all work are taking place. Getting a point? You know, administrative reform process depends on several things. Getting a point, if you enlist all the factors, then only one you can expect whether it will become successful or failure. In general, the success of administrative reform depends on, you know, congruence with felt needs of the system and its beneficiary. If a beneficiary or a stakeholder feel its need and they are very much expressive it, then only it will become successful. Then public support and a feeling of sharing of a reform goal is also important. Then timing is very significant now. Effective source of initiation means from where it has started. Suppose Prime Minister himself started, then it is guarantee of success. Rather than if he started by local level authority, then you can say political will matter a lot. Administrative entrepreneurship matters significantly for success of administrative reform. Then participation of key stakeholder in a strategy for implementation, if you enlist, it is success guarantee, giving guarantee of success. You should require pragmatic and flexible approach. An effective reward and punishment system should be there. Then there should be continuing evaluation and appraisal also to correct it in course of time. Then there should be institutionalization of reform. If you ensure all these things, then success of administrative reform becomes significant. Getting point? Again, I repeat it. What are factors responsible for success of administrative reform? First, the need of the there should be expressed need of beneficiary and stakeholder for administrative reform. Then political public support, feeling of sharing, timing, effective source of initiation means who has started it, then political will, then administrative entrepreneurship, then participation of key stakeholder, then pragmatic and flexibility approach, then you can say effective reward and punishment, then continuous evaluation and appraisal, then institutionalization of reform. These are parameters. On the other hand, there are certain hurdles or hindrances in resistance to reform also, because you know when you do any sort of change, it changes status quo. That's why it is supposed to create resistance also. So what can be the things? Then you can say the first of all, you can say the perceived or real threat to the power position of affected actors. If they feel that this administrative reform make a detriment for their interest, they start opposing it. Then vested interest, definitely lack of political will, next definitely political apathy or antipathy, then administrative inexperience or indifference, very nice, imposition from above approach, then ambiguity about implication, people are not sure what it will cause, then inflexibility, then ad hocism, and last individualism rather than institutionalism. If these things are there, then there is chances of hurdles in the way of all administrative reform. And you can find in empirical perspective also, when people feel that it is a detriment to them, they start opposing it. That's why administrative reform has been prolonged for a long period and problem continues. That's why I told in the beginning that it has mixed response. Definitely it has brought significant changes in some sector, but unfortunately several areas are yet to be reformed. This you require. So presently 21st century, we require some significant approach, new subject matter in administration reform, because in 21st century situation is quite different. Present government is pursuing towards Atmanirbhar Bharat and the new India formation. In this situation, you require different set of administration reform. So what should be items included under administration reform? First, you can say linking organizational, the administrative reform should address linking organizational goal with governmental goal. Then administrative reform should address proactive approach. Then administrative reform should address adaptive capacity to environmental changes. Then it should also incorporate brainstorming. Then it should also give a space for ethical base for of government. Then it should address sound system of policy making. It should have a space for more power and role to a specialist. Then it should have also address sound system of intelligence with effective antenna device. Then it should also concern for time management, self management, art of work innovation. Then it should also encourage innovative measures. Getting point, it should also work on network on extraction with research and training. Then it should develop system of consultation, consensus, collaboration and cooperation. And last, it should also address crisis management. So now presently, these are subject matter of administrative reform, which the government requires or country requires to address. So administrative reform topic is full of potentiality, full of challenges, full of, you can say, complexity, full of, you can say potentiality. So one requires to be very concerned, very serious, very, you can say, pragmatic, wheresoever your administrative reform is concerned and its implication and, you can say, impact on administration, administrative system are concerned. So if you have vision for Atmanirbhar Bharat or if you have vision for independent new India, then you require to change the issue of administrative reform and take new course of action to address. Okay, all the best. So if your question comes on Bihar segment, you require the same sort of answer that in Bihar the same situations are there. Bihar is also having number of problem and it requires same set of situation in Bihar also and it has done also in that regard. So Bihar has to introduce Lokpal, your governance, citizen charter, then you can say right to information, right to services, right to public grievances. Bihar is moving. This topic I will address when I will go for public grievance redressal. So today I will close this topic. I will give you one as question asked in 5659 and try to write and post to me. I have already discussed the question. I will request you to take up this question and post to me. The question was discuss the view of administrative reform in India since independence. You try to write and post to me. Okay, thanks, enjoy.